Hi, Bug.
Hi, Bug.
Hi, Bugs.
This is my girlfriend, Alyssa.
And this is my girlfriend,
Lauren.
And today we're going to be answering some of your pretty little DMs you sent us over on our Instagram.
Yes.
Make sure that you're following our Instagrams, y'all, because every once in a while we're going on our little stories. We're saying, ask us go questions.
Please do.
We will answer it in a YouTube video.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what we're doing right now.
Yeah, very fun. But before we answer questions, are you subscribed?
Have you liked this video?
Did you comment? Oh, I had a question, but I didn't have time to ask it. Oh, shoot.
Also, if you did, you can always DM us. Have you hit that little bell?
Ding, ding, ding.
To be notified every time we post, because we're posting three times a week.
Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
We're like little robots.
Yeah, we are. It's kind of fun. It feels like, once again, like we're flight attendants.
Yeah. All right, let's get into this little Q&A.
Perfect.
First question I would like to answer, because mm-hmm. I'm always seeing this person comment on our YouTube videos, and I would like to reward loyalty.
There you go.
Is from, I'm not even gonna say it, because I don't wanna dox you, but you know who
True.
You are. You know who you are.
I love to you.
Two things. Number one, I love you, Bug Mother Queens. Yes, that's how I recognize you, because you're always commenting, I love you, Bug Mother Queens,
yes.
on our YouTube videos.
Yes.
And let me say, I love you, Bug Child.
We are your mothers, you are
Number two, how do you be confident? I think for me, something that really changed my life is literally, it's so cliche of the fake it till you make it.
Exactly.
But that is how you do it. Honestly, mm-hmm. I remember like feeling, for example, a few years ago, I wasn't super confident about my body.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember hearing this advice, right? Of just like speaking what I wanted to feel. Mm-hmm. So I remember being like, I'm so hot. Like just to myself.
Yeah.
And then to my close friends, like, oh, I'm so hot. And now I'm like, I'm so hot. Knock, knock, world. I'm hot.
I think when we're feeling insecure, we sort of go into ourselves and we're like, oh, like I could never wear that because I could never pull that off. Or I could never like go there because I don't like myself. And so I can't like leave the house today. Forcing yourself to, first of all, wear what you want to wear.
True.
Enjoy the hobbies that you want to enjoy.
Yes.
Like, don't just say you want to do something and don't do it. Follow through with it.
Do it.
The days that I feel the best and the most confident are the days that I've, like, spent time putting together my outfit. And I've spent a little time doing my makeup. Or, like, sometimes you're in a rush. Sometimes I feel like when I'm in a rush, I look the cutest.
Yeah.
Because I'm, like, panicking and then I'm, like, I'm flawless.
If you're feeling not super confident about, like, say, your personality or chatting with people, just remember that people are inclined to want to hear what you say unless you give them a reason not to.
Mm-hmm.
So unless you're being like a little bratty or a little rude,
true.
Like people are typically interested in what you have to say.
It's true. I also think something that's helped me, some people don't like this, but this has helped me. People think about themselves so much more than they think about you.
Absolutely.
So you're overanalyzing, you're thinking about yourself, and maybe you do something a little weird, or you're like, oh, I feel insecure about like the way I acted or like what I wore that day. Chances are people aren't gonna remember it. And if they do remember it, they're probably the strange ones.
They are the strange ones. Like, for example, I think something to like enunciate this point is, if you've ever posted like an Instagram picture with a friend,
mm-hmm.
think about how long you analyze your face in the photo versus how long you analyze your friend's face.
Because yeah, exactly. I feel like my friends have posted, and no hate to my friends, but I feel like my friends post the quackiest pictures of me.
And but they look fire.
But they look fabulous. And but it's also like, it's your Instagram, post what you want. I can untag myself if I want to. And yeah. That's power.
And that's power. Untag yourself. That's how to be confident.
Confidence goes hand in hand with happiness.
Yeah.
So just like try to seek joy every day. And if you're seeking joy in your own way through whatever way you do, you will gain confidence mm-hmm. because you will be at a happier state.
Absolutely. Next question.
Okay. I want to share this. This is an update on one of our previous Q&As. I remember doing this question. I'm the girly who was questioning if I was bi or lesbian while in a long-term relationship with a man.
I remember this question
uh-huh.
too.
And I have to report that I'm no longer in a relationship and I'm currently identifying as a lesbian. Your video helped me and encouraged me a lot, and watching your content always makes me happy.
Oh, we're glad for you.
I'm happy for you.
Not because you're like, I'm a lesbian and I'm biased. No, I'm happy for you. Yeah, a little bit. I love lesbians.
It's true.
I just love them.
Yeah.
But I'm happy for you that you got to explore this new part of yourself.
That's wonderful. And how brave of you
yes.
to end a relationship that was probably nice and comfortable. Yeah. And I hope the person that you ended the relationship is doing well as well.
Yeah.
Hoping but the best for the both of you.
I'm happy for you. I'm giving you a hug.
Wonderful. The cam. Yeah, congratulations.
And welcome to the lesbian family. I'm welcoming you with big arms.
I'm so happy for you. This is actually a question. How to not gay panic and how to be the one taking the lead on a date. And then they gave me context, which I don't think we need to include.
Okay.
But I'm reading the context and I'm sending you love on it. I think that we can answer it more broadly.
Yeah. The way that we act and the words that we say can affect how we feel so much. So if you want to be the more dominant one on the date, fake it till you make it, mm-hmm. baby. Mm-hmm. Like, it truly, you're never gonna feel ready to be the dominant one. You yeah. just have to start being it. Mm-hmm. If you want to initiate a first kiss, you have to take it into your own mm-hmm. hands. You have to, like, give yourself that power. Even if you're shaking in your boots on the inside, mm-hmm. on the outside, you just gotta, like, imagine your hottest, most confident self and then act like how you would imagine they would act. It yeah. might feel like a little farce. It might feel like you're playing a character, but aren't we all at the end of the day?
I agree. I think that you're not going to do anything until you force yourself to do it. At least for me, some of us are born more dominant. I mean, I kind of am and I'm kind of not. Especially if you're new to, you know, being gay. It's harder to be dominant because you're in a place where you're like, I've never done this before. So it's hard to be confident with anything you haven't done before. I think you just have to force yourself. That's how Lauren and I got together. I DM'd her because I found out that we were living in the same city, which is not something that I would normally do, but it was pride and I was feeling some type of way.
Proud.
it was pride and I was feeling proud.
And she DM'd me, and then I was bold when I said, can I kiss you?
Uh-huh. And then I tried to ask her to be my girlfriend, and she said no.
Because, no, because I had a whole date planned for the next day that I'd been planning.
It a was couple special, days.
And I had crafts, and I had, yeah. I was like, ask me again in a few days.
Mm-hmm. And then so on and so forth. What does gay panic mean to you?
Gay panic is like,
because that's the other aspect of this
getting
question.
Overwhelmed with maybe how attractive someone else is, but also maybe your inability to act mm-hmm. on your attraction, on your own attraction.
Honestly, I don't know that I've ever experienced that.
Well, you're also somebody who...
I'm very much not a panicker, I would
say. You're not a panicker, but also I think you're very much somebody whose attraction stems from knowing someone already.
And yeah, I think gay so panic, with strangers, I'm like, I don't know you.
Yeah, but I feel like gay panic, I relate to this. Like, when mm-hmm. you see a really hot person and you're like, it's trying to talk, but it's slow-mo. Mm-hmm. Like, I get you. You just gotta take a deep breath. And remember, at the end of the day, mm-hmm. every hot person is just a person.
Yeah. I think the reason that I'm not is that I'm very much like, you are just a person. Like, I think that's how I go into it, like, from the start.
Yeah, you rock that you've never experienced that, but I relate. I believe in you. Mm-hmm. What are your favorite movies?
Oh, I think we've addressed this before, but maybe we'll add on to it. My all-time favorite movie is She's the Man. I'm an Amanda Bynes stan.
One time we saw Amanda Bynes in public and
yes,
I was freaking out.
I was freaking out too.
We saw her and I grabbed Alyssa's hand and I said, babe, Amanda Bynes.
It was really exciting. It was really exciting.
My favorite movie is Romeo and Michelle's High School Reunion. It is the best movie ever, and I encourage you to watch it and imagine that the two women are gay.
Yes. And then
and it's very easy to imagine that as well.
Yeah, it's true. And then I think we should say our favorite movies from this year to make it like a little different. Ooh. We've said our favorite movies before.
From this year as in like from 2024
or that we've seen recently.
That we've seen like recently. Okay, because I think Everything
but not like
All
something
at Once
told.
Came out a while ago, but it blew my mind and I loved it.
I loved Lisa Frankenstein.
Lisa Frankenstein was so good.
I thought it was so good. I thought that girl was so charming. Do you know her name?
Catherine Newton.
I thought she was charming.
Yes.
That's
a very fun one. That's a movie.
Cole Sprouse barely spoke, thank God.
That movie is done by the same person who did Jennifer's Body, mm-hmm. and it's
and
just
Juno.
As campy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, very
yeah.
good.
It's like a good combination of the two. And then I also loved a little older Theater Camp.
Oh my God, Theater Camp was so fun.
I hope all of you have seen it because it's darling and charming and appropriate for all ages, I would say.
Theater Camp was so fun. Mm-hmm. I love Theater Camp. Mm-hmm. We are AMC A-list members. Yes. So we're going to the movies and we're watching the thing.
We see everything.
I really liked
Poor Things. Oscar winner.
Also controversial movie, but I liked Poor Things. That is not a movie to watch with your parents.
No. Except for I would watch it with my mom. But we're built different.
You guys are built different. I would not watch it. Okay, next question.
Okay. Heidi asks, any reason why we, the devout audience, are called bugs? Love it, as well as you and Lauren.
Oh,
that is so sweet. You guys are called bugs because a lot of times Lauren and I just call each other bug.
We've been, since the very early stages of our relationship, we assigned two emojis to each other, and Alyssa is the ladybug emoji, and I'm the green beetle, and they're both bugs. And so we just call each other bug all the time.
Yeah, and we love to send each other the emojis, like if we're gonna like have ice cream later, I'll send ladybug emoji, ice cream emoji,
green beetle emoji. We use them as little placeholders for ourselves, but we call each other bug, and we've been calling each other bugs for a long time. And then I think when we first started the channel, we were like, we should have something.
Some like little intro.
A little intro that, I don't know, is familiar our for calling our audience. Card. Yeah, and we were like,
what do we do?
And then bugs.
Yeah, and then it was like, hi bugs. Bye bugs.
Yeah.
Bugs. And then, so it really happened like pretty organically. We didn't have to think very hard about it.
No, because it was just something we were already saying, and we still say it all the time to each other, yeah, even when like, the camera's off. Bug.
We have all sorts of nicknames for each other.
Yes, but bug is
it
our
has
one with
stayed
you.
Consistent. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Would you believe that I'm the green beetle and she's the ladybug?
Of course.
I feel like it makes sense.
Of course.
Okay, this one says, are you gonna get any pets?
Ugh.
I had a dream about this last night.
Ugh. Yes, we are.
Yes, not for a while, probably.
We have exciting news also. We're cat sitting.
We're cat sitting.
So that's soon. Huge.
Maybe.
Because I really want a cat bad.
Yes, she wants to get a kitten, but we don't want our own cat quite yet.
We're not there.
So we're cat sitting.
Yeah.
Coming up.
Mm-hmm.
And it's exciting for us because we'll get to see what a cat looks like in our house.
And I grew up with cats, so I have a very special place in my heart for them. We're going to get a dog after we have a baby. but we're going to get a cat first before all of that.
And we have names picked out.
Or maybe two. Yeah.
We're not going to tell you yet.
Yeah.
Because I feel like name reveal.
Yeah, and they might change, but we have current names.
We have current, yeah, we've already.
But yeah.
Oh my god, that clip of JoJo Siwa saying she wants triplets and she already has them named and she has them tattooed on her and it's Freddy, Teddy, and Eddie. Sorry, that was a lot to drop.
I didn't know this. Horrid. I didn't know this.
Horrid. Horrid, rancid.
Oh my goodness.
Freddy, Teddy, and Eddie. It's like she's doing Alvin and the Chipmunks.
Oh my god. No, it's like Ed, and Eddie.
Yeah, Fred, Teddy, and Eddie.
I don't like that. I'm sorry, Miss JoJo.
And people are saying, does your wife get a say? Apparently not.
No, probably not. Somebody asked me, as a bisexual person, have you ever dealt with compet? I am not currently bisexual, but I have dealt with compet. And that's hard.
Yes. Miss Alyssa,
I think we all have,
unlabeled.
Right? I think we all have dealt with compet, right? Because you just don't know that anything else exists when you're a little baby.
Yeah, when you're a little baby walking around in the world.
But I hope that that's different now. I hope that younger people are immediately knowing that gay people exist, because I remember when I learned that lesbians exist.
Well, it's not even just not knowing that gay people exist.
And it was older than it should have been, I feel like.
I think it's more than that. It's knowing that you can be gay, but feeling like you should be not.
That's true.
So
that's true.
I think that's, even if you know that gay people exist from a very long time, maybe you're like, well, I'm not one of them. Or,
well, I feel like knowing that gay people exist helps you to realize that it's okay, because usually if you know a gay person, they're accepted in your community.
Hopefully.
Do you know what I mean?
Hopefully.
I mean, usually like the first gay person that I met was in my family and she was very accepted.
So, I think you're a lucky duck. I think this is where our backstories are vastly different.
That's
because
true.
I didn't meet a gay person until college. So
that's not true. You
no.
met your lovers.
Oh yeah. Oh, I met. You're right.
Yeah.
This is where our backstories differ, because Alyssa knew gay people from a very young age. The first gay person I met was in high school, and I didn't know any gay adults. I only knew the girls I dated in high school and the people I dated in high school, but I didn't know any gay adults.
Mm-hmm. Did you know I had lesbian neighbors?
I feel like yes.
I went to their vow renewal.
Yeah,
in their backyard,
you told me this. I'm so jealous.
As a child.
I didn't know any gay adults. The only gay people I knew that were adults were online through a screen.
Mm-hmm.
Which is why part of why I want to be a gay adult for people on screen, because that was such a big part of me accepting myself and growing to love my identity. And that's why I do this now.
Yeah. There you go. That's so beautiful.
And I feel so lucky.
That's so beautiful.
And you know what? Sometimes people ask, they're like, do you mind if people come up to you in public? It is my favorite thing ever.
Oh, yeah.
It is my favorite thing ever because
people are really sweet.
It reminds me, like, why I started doing this in the first place and why I continue to do this even when I don't want to. Mm-hmm. Like, not that I ever really don't want to. I love to do it because
when we're being lazy.
Yes, when I'm being lazy and I don't want to put on my makeup and I don't want to make a video about how to ask out a girl.
Yeah.
And I still do it. And then somebody comes up to me in public and they're like, you are helping me be comfortable with my identity. It makes it 1,000,000 times worth it.
Exactly.
It makes it 1,000,000 times worth it. I had a very, very sweet interaction.
Just the other day.
At a concert. Mm-hmm. Sally, shout out to you if you're watching this. Young girl came up to me and was telling me some very sweet things. And it just, it really stuck with me. It mm-hmm. really stuck. I will never forget this little girl's name. Mm-hmm. I will never forget that interaction. It's one of my favorite interactions I've ever had from my online career. I don't know. It makes me really emotional to think that something that really helped me when I was younger, I get to continue, but turn around and help other people.
Yeah.
My friends, when I talk to them about being sapphic, say they don't understand how you could differentiate between platonic and romantic feelings like you could with a man. And I never really explain it to them. How would you explain, like, WLW love? So this is interesting to me because if your friends have any man friends, mm-hmm. that's how you differentiate.
Yeah.
You know, if they have boys in their life who they're not romantically interested in, then it's platonic. And it's the same thing. It's the same, that's what I would say to them. And if they don't have any friends who are boys, then I would say,
you're lucky. Just kidding.
I would say,
just joshing.
I would say, you don't have to understand it, mama.
Yeah.
Cause you're not dating girls.
Yeah, it's also like, why do you want to know so bad, baby?
Yeah, you got
I think it's just like, when you know, you know. And this is for the girlies who are like dating boys. You know when you're like kind of starting to talk to somebody and then you're like, oh, this is never gonna be romantic. And you kind of like are like, oh, I'm kind of talking to this person now, but I'm never gonna like them. It's the same thing as that.
Yeah.
And then you would just like be friends with that person instead of wanting to date them.
Yeah. Or even not even friends. Like, if a boy approaches one of your friends and is like, I want you bad, and the friend is like, I don't feel that way towards you, you could be like, okay, that feeling is how I feel towards girls who I'm not into.
Yeah.
Do you get that? You know?
Yeah, I think it's interesting. You probably have experienced this a lot. Like, you've made a lot of friends from first dates. Like, you know pretty quickly.
Yeah.
When you're not driving
I'm
with someone
very
romantically.
Decisive about that stuff. Mm-hmm. I'm very decisive about mm-hmm. that stuff. And ultimately, at the end of the day, what matters most is not even that your friends completely understand it, but that they support you regardless.
Yeah, it's nice that they're asking.
Yeah.
As long as it's not in a weird way.
As long as it's respectful and not, yeah. like, dismissive.
I hope that you get to talk to them about your relationships in the same way that they get to talk to you about their relationships.
I hope you do too. Mm-hmm. And I highly encourage you, if possible, to make some other WLW friends who
it's
you can
huge.
Relate to.
It's huge.
It's like a hug. It's like a hug on the inside.
Yeah. Cause it is different.
Yeah.
It is different, not in a bad way.
This one says, is there a point of accepting myself as a lesbian if I can't come out to anyone? It's not safe. Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Because it might not be safe now. You might not be able to come out to the people around you now, but one day, I hope and I manifest for you that you'll be in a situation in which you can come out. And also, I think accepting yourself is so important, mm-hmm. regardless of what the other people around you think, because if there's one person you're gonna spend your life with, it's you. And that sounds cheesy and corny, but it's true. And I feel like embracing yourself is a way to show yourself love.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I'm sorry that you're in that situation, but I agree, you absolutely should make an effort to try and accept yourself and be happy with yourself, because at the end of the day, you're the only one that you're gonna be with forever. And if it's your family that's the problem, family can be important, but you can also make your own family. And just because they are your family doesn't mean that they should be able to treat you poorly. I know you're probably in a situation where you cannot get away from the people you're around, mm. but I hope that eventually you will be, and that you will be able to come out and, if you would like to, and be around people who are more respectful.
Yeah. That you can be yourself around. Mm-hmm. But it's absolutely worth it. Mm-hmm. I feel like it's just a way to show yourself love. Mm-hmm.
Because at the end of the day, like, you're still going to be thinking about it, so you might as well be thinking good thoughts about
positively about it.
Yeah, because if you're just, like, it's never good to have self-hate.
No.
Unless you did something bad, which you didn't.
You didn't. Unless you did, but it's not being
gay. It's not being gay, no. Thank you for sending us your questions, freakies!
Oh, you have a kiss mark on your little cheek still.
And good.
What if we called you freakies instead of bugs? Freaky bugs.
I love to call people freakies.
Yes, you do.
I love you, bugs.
Make sure that you are subscribed.
Uh-huh.
Make sure that you liked.
Uh-huh.
Make sure you commented.
Uh-huh.
Make sure you're dinging that bell.
Ding, ding, ding.
To get notified every time we post.
We post three times a week.
Monday, Wednesday, Friday.
And follow us on our socials to send us questions for more videos like this.
Hoo-hoo.
Bye.
Bye.
Bye.